In 1981, I'm invited to perform in the most extraordinary place, China, for the first time for a Western musician for 30 years. I have the opportunity to play in China, and for me, and I think for them, it was like playing on the moon. Then I decide to do an album around this project that will be Concert in China. And Concert in China, actually, it's a live album, but it's also a studio album because half of this double album is new. So for me, I always considered that Concert in China is a new album. And also, it's the period where I really start to explore also all the new sequences. It's the beginning of MIDI, and then I have lots of tracks such as Arpeggiator, based on long sequences and orchestration, arrangement of sequences. And also, it's the continuation of the constant experimentation, experimenting with Chinese sounds of the street, of noise, in a track such as Souvenir of China, for instance. And then it was also an extraordinary situation to play in stadiums, both in Beijing and Shanghai, and having lots of Chinese audience with us on stage with extraordinary electronic instruments and with a very futuristic stage design and project show in a country that would close its doors the next following month. So it has been really something very special for me, of course, but also I think for the Chinese people. This whole story started through the British Embassy, which gave my albums to the Chinese radio. And they played it for the first time. They played non-Chinese music. And then I've been invited in Beijing for a masterclass at the official public music school of Beijing. And then I left there a synthesizer, the first electronic instrument in China, and they created around this first visit and this first instrument, the first class of electronic music in China.